Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on auto layout with tiny constraints. All of this, of course, in Swift 5. So without further ado, let's jump right into today's episode. Okay. In the previous episode, we have learned about centering our views, center Y and center X to our constrainables, so other views. And if you scroll a little bit down in this file, you will see that we have an extension for our view with set hugging priority for axis and set compression resistance priority for axis. We'll talk about that maybe in a later video. But for now, let us just jump into some awesome new territory, and that is stacks. And if you don't know what I'm talking about here and you really are confused what I'm talking about, go ahead and take a look at the whole playlist. We are talking about auto layout with tiny constraints, and till up to this moment we have learned how to anchor views to the super view and anchor views to themselves. So we are just moving views and within views, of course. But today we are going to talk about this awesome extension called stack. And as you can see, it takes in an array of views, and you can set its axis. Of course, it can be vertical or horizontal, and you could set optionally width or and the height, and you can of course set a spacing, and this current default spacing is zero, which is okay. So let's see all of this in action so you can see the power of this stack extension. And you might be asking, well, we have UI a stack view, why do we want to use this? Well, it's kind of easier to use this stack extension, and it is fitting right into the tiny constraints ecosystem. So let's do that today. And let's go back to our root view controller setup views Swift file. And as you can see, I have already added some more views, and I'm adding all of them into our view. So we are adding them as subviews. We are not adding range subviews or anything like that, as you would do on a UI stack view. So let's start coding. So first of all, let's arrange our view one, and that will be our container. Okay, so view one, and I will edge this to our super view, and I'm going to use this with excluding insets and so on. And if you again don't know what this really means, go ahead and take a look at the previous videos. I go into that how to use these, and you will see the link down below to the whole playlist. So edges to super view, excluding bottom. Insets, I will add in here some tiny insets because, yeah, I don't want to make them stretch all the way to the sides. And for the top, I will add in 12 left, 12. Bottom zero, because yeah, that is what we are excluding, and 12 for the right. And relation, priority and is active can be omitted because I'm pretty fine with the default values. Of course, I will talk about this later in a next video, so we'll demystify all of these. But for now, let's add using safe area true. And for this to show up, we still need to add a height for our view. And yeah, if you are brand new to this video, that is how easy it is to add a view. And I will have this as a height of 300. So two lines of code and adding this to the view. And there we go. We have our view one edge to the super view with insets and with a height of 300. Okay, now that's that. Now we want to add, let's see here, view two and view three as a stack. So let's do that. Let's type in view one and stack. And we will use this long one, so stack views, axis, width, height, and spacing, so we can get accustomed to. If not, you may omit it, because you can use the default values, of course. And let's add in here our array, so that is view 2 and view 3. There we go. Axis, let it be By default, this is vertical. I'm just adding here vertical, just so you can see. And the width and the height, let's omit this. So let's add in nil here for now, because let's just see how all of this looks like. And spacing, let's add in here, rather at 12, it's or 16. That's a magic number that I like to use. Okay, and let's see how this looks like. And as you can see, we do have this spacing added here, but all we can see is this blue view one and the orange one. If we go back to our root view controller, it's basically view three. So we can't see view two, that is the green one. So what goes here? Well, the issue here is that while we do have our vertical axis selected, that means that the width of our view 2 and view 3 are already set, but the height isn't set. So let's set in here our height, so CG size, or rather that it's not a CG size, it's just a float. So let's add in here 100 for the size. Okay, let's see what happens here. Okay, and yeah, now you can see the green one. And you can see the background or the container view one with the blue one with a spacing of 16. And this one, the view three isn't 100. And as you can see here, we have some errors, and it basically says that the height of our master tiny constraints, the view one, is 300. As you can see, we have set that correctly. And it's trying to add all of these views with a height of 100. And yeah, that is basically not correct, because we want to fill everything here and we still are missing 100 minus the spacing, and that is 84. And we are breaking one height, and that is the height of our view 3. So yeah, that's what this means. So what we could do here is basically, let's change the spacing to 10, because it's much easier to calculate. So we have 10 here, and let's have this 310, and let's add 150 for the height. So yeah, that will make sense, because we have two 150 height views and one spacing of 10. So that is how it goes. But yeah, maybe you don't want to have this height set as 150 for both of these views. So let's set this back to nil, or we could just simply delete it. It doesn't really matter. And now, before we stack these views, or I believe it could be added even without later on or the other line, let's add our height specifically for view 2. And let's see, let this be 100, and let the view of the height of view 3 be 200. Let's see, height 200. So let's not break any constraints here. Of course, you may break it, and auto layout, we try to guess everything that you want to do, but it's always a good idea to not have these breaking constraints in your log. Okay, so yeah, that is how you can set separate heights. But what if there's a lot of calculations and I don't really know how to calculate this? Maybe it's dynamic. What do we do here? Let's see, let's set this to 500 by default, and let's build and run. And we do want to have this to be 200. And of course you will see that again we have these issues, and it's spanning all the way down. Now a neat trick here is that you could add an empty UI view, and that will span that extra length. Okay, so let's build a run, and you will see how the view 3 is actually now 200 in height. Now another thing that we could do is basically be sure that we have heights for all of the views that are inside the container view 1, and just simply omit this. And let me just delete view this empty view, and let's build and run and see that yeah, it's actually self-sizing this. And just for fun, you can see the blue one is not there. If I add in here Let's just add back here our UI view so we can get that spacing, because yeah, this is a view and its height will be zero because it's an empty view, but we still have this spacing. And just for fun, let's add in here 500. Let's see how that looks and see that it is, yes, basically it is auto sizing. Yeah, really cool, isn't it? So I would rather delete this and have this to, let's say, 200. Okay. And yeah, this is for vertical stacks. And of course, we still have this view 5 and view 4. So what are we going to do? Well, we are going to stack them horizontally. And let me just build run again so we get this height with 200. So we are going to create a horizontal stack. And yeah, let's just add it. So under or anywhere else, as a matter of fact, let's add our view 3 a stack. So stack, and that stack will be containing view 4 and view 5. Okay, axis should be horizontal, of course, and of course you can add vertical inside the vertical, but yeah, it doesn't really make sense. Maybe if you want to change spacing, yeah, that is a good idea. Let me just show you how that goes and then we will move on to the horizontal. So here we have our vertical space stack, and with the width nil and the height, yeah, let's add in a height of, let's say, 100. Let's just add in 50 because yeah, that will. And let's add in here a spacing of 20. So double of the spacing that we have here. Let's build and run and see how this looks like. Okay, so what have we achieved here? Well, basically we have, and let me just move this a little bit down so you can see the code too. So we have our blue container view, that is view 1, and it has a spacing of 10. And it has two views, the green one and the orange one. And the orange one also contains two views, this purple one and red one, but the spacing here is 20. So it's 20. And yeah, that is basically it. So yeah. And of course, because we set the height of 50, this and we didn't add any UI views, then the blue red one, let me just add in our UI view and show you what we are going to fix. This red one is stretching all the way down to the size of our orange view. So let's hit Command R again, and now we should really see that we have this height. Okay, there we go. Pretty nice. And now we have these two 50s. Okay, and that is how you can manage spacing when you don't want to have the same spacing all over the place. So now let us just delete all of this and finally talk about horizontal axis. So it will be a horizontal axis, and I will set the width now to 50, and the height should be nil because yeah, it should auto resize according to view freeze height, and yeah, the spacing should be 20. That is okay with me. So let's build and run and see how this looks like. And you will basically see that the red view is stretching all the way up here, and it is breaking some constraints. Let me just see what is wrong here. Yes, we are not setting a view here. So let's see, UI view, there we go. And let's hit Command R, and hopefully we are getting rid of all of these. And I believe we didn't. So again, let's set this to nil, and let's set all of our views heights go programmatically with the height. So view 4 dot width, sorry, we are going to set the width to 50, and view 5 dot width, let's set this to 100. Okay, let's see how this works. And again, all of this works. Yeah, we should use this width and height only when we want to have this stack as with the same width slash height elements. Okay, and yeah, that is it basically. We now know everything that we need to know. Just one thought here. What if we wanted to have this here? So let's add this aligned to the right. So view 4 and view 5 should be aligned to the right. And that is what we have to do. Pretty straightforward. And all of this with just a few lines of code. Now, that was super awesome. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video of Tiny Constraints with Stack. I know this is kind of a hidden feature of Tiny Constraints, but it is really, really powerful. Now, I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out, because in the next video, we are going to talk about animations. So that will be a really interesting topic. As usual, I will see you in the next one.